Fox 4's Stephen Dial spoke with the Dallas County Health Director about what he is seeing in the numbers and what this might mean for a possible peak. Stephen.
Blake, this is indeed the deadliest week so far when it comes to coronavirus-related deaths, 33 in the last 7 days. County health leaders say the deaths and cases will continue to increase.
Saturday, Dallas County saw the most reported coronavirus cases, 134 new cases and 5 deaths. 3 of the 5 people lived in Dallas nursing homes. This week alone, there were 33 COVID-19 deaths in the county.
Is it too early to say that Dallas County has reached its peak?
Yeah, we do not think we've reached the peak yet. I mean, there have been different estimates. You know, we've been saying some of the models are looking like end of April, early May. Some of those, you know, maybe show a little earlier than that. But we're continuing to just monitor, you know, all the information that we have and refine the models and have ongoing sort of evaluation.
Dr. Phil Wong is with Dallas County Health and Human Services. Wong says the stay-at-home order is working as the models show the county is nearing the peak of its curve. A large portion of the cases are from people with underlying health conditions like diabetes. But young and healthy people are not immune to the virus. Wong says people need to stay at home when they can or continue to wear face coverings when you go out.
This increased recognition of asymptomatic spread, that, you know, how prevalent that is, how much that is probably contributing to some of the spread of the infection, so that these face coverings, they don't necessarily protect the wearer, but if that person has, you know, is asymptomatically infected or pre-symptomatic, that helps protect others from those droplets that the person might get from coughing or even from just talking.
The amount of tests that can be done at American Airlines Center and Ellis Davis Fieldhouse have been expanded. Soon, there will be a testing site at one Walgreens location in Dallas. Wong says more testing will be the key way to determine when businesses should fully reopen.
You know, we all want things to open up as soon as they can, but none of us wants to open things up too soon to get, you know, sort of that, you know, where we rebound and get into the situation that we've been trying to prevent all along with this. So I think that there's, you know, still more evaluation and some of the experts are being consulted regarding this.
And nursing homes remain the top concern for county health leaders. 3 of the 5 deaths, as you mentioned, Blake, were nursing home related today.
Okay, Stephen Dial live for us. Thanks so much.